NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers, or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. And make plays like that.
Hello, people. It's been a while. I'm back. Just doing some random games.
Set to kick off.
One of my favorites for right now. I'll probably be doing some Black Ops Cold War later.
An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. Oh, a good return up past the 30.
Washington takes over first and 10 at their own 30.
Now Washington going to retake the field for drive number two.
Yeah, that sounds lovely.
Last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
Yeah, he tried to run through me.
Frustrated. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Philip Dorsett, the intended receiver, and it's third down. Gun. They'll look to throw, and that is incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you overthink things. Get back to what works.
It's all right, though.
He's going to field this at the four. No, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
An excellent return that time, 26 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Jones now on first and 10. To Shepard, complete over the middle. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That's good for 28 yards. Oh, he fakes a spike. And knocked away. It's incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. But it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 10.
Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
7 yard line.
Throwing Jones. Strong coverage by Washington. And now fourth down.
And trying to get the ball to his tight end in the center of the field where he runs a lot of his routes and ostensibly is extremely comfortable. He was hoping he'd find a seam and a big gainer to go along with it. But that one.
Fourth and 5. And Ingram with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
That while I was supposed to get on last night, but I forgot.
Near the goal line, quick slant. Nice job there to get in, knock it away.
It was. One of the other things you're concerned about when you throw that route is to make sure your offensive linemen use their leverage to get the hands of the defensive front down so you can throw it through that little bit of crowd and get it to the receiver. In this event, they did, but a nice play by the defender knocking it away.
An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position.
So you're saying I need to get on so you can get more battle pets, baby?
And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive.
You need more battle pets?
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Blake Jarwin, the intended receiver, but now it's third down.
Jabril Pepper is on the coverage.
Oh, he got to me.
Sims, he's got it.
Fuck, I didn't want him to get a touchdown.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington.
Yeah.
Steven Sims, his first touchdown on the year.
And Washington able to cut into that deficit.
Well, since we don't have a rooting interest in this one, neither one of us wanted to see this one get out of hand too early.
They'll cut the lead to 21-7. And a nice return. Ready to begin their next drive. They begin with a run by Barkley. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. No, he didn't spike it. He faked it. That's caught inside the 20.
Got him.
And he's going to get into the end zone. So the fake spike works, and they score. Evan Engram doing it again with his third touchdown here in the opening quarter. And the Giants add on to their lead. Jones throwing for it. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And that bumps their lead up even further. And the formula there on the two-point try to go five wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that if someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind
you. I will swaddle you.
But in this case, the offense figured it out.
First and 10. At their own 34-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline.
Philip Dorsett by himself. And they do.
He ain't going far.
Get him, but he takes it to the 25.
He almost scored.
That's the end of the first quarter.
End of the first quarter.
To this one. More to come on EA Sports.
Now we're in a second.
They'll run on first down. It's Gibson. They'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of four.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to home and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel
damn
good
it, I couldn't
yourself.
Strip the ball.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the five.
He's at the 5 yard
line. Like you would a typical boxing match. Right. The person is on his heels and absorbing blows. It's having a tough time. That's what's happening to the defense right now because the offense is on his toes and punching. And there was another first down run right there.
And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the two. From the two now, second and goal. A gain of three brings up second and goal. They'll look to run with Edwards.
Ah, he fucking mushed me.
Touchdown. Gus Edwards, his third touchdown now on the year. And Washington able to close the gap just a bit. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you.
All right,
totally
14-29.
I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line. Because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know
he
each
couldn't
other and execute their blocks
truck through that crap.
Impressive.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Here's Jones on first down, and he rifles one
really
incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Those shoulders went from parallel to square. And then he brought force with him to finish that run. Oh, that's impressive.
And we saw a lot of that a week ago when he got the NFC Offensive Player of the Week award. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 19 yards there on the catch and run. In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 43. Operating from the gun. Jones. Over the middle complete. It's Shepard. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
16-yard line.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. Now Saquon Barkley. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year.
All right, Sterling Shepard.
The Giants are able to grow their lead. And certainly some credit there for that touchdown goes to the offensive line.
They get the credit they deserve in the stat sheet, but they are the reason that they got the points. Excellent job up front, clearing the way for the score.
Gano now.
Anything new, baby?
Here to kick it away.
Anything new?
Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
What about you working?
At their own 33-yard line.
Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. A lot of the problems have been on the other side of the ball. Is that frustrating for a quarterback who's been playing well?
It is, but there's no way that the best ones let their teammates know that. They actually take it upon themselves and say, okay, I have to do even more, or I need to play better, or maybe even say I put my defense in a bad spot. That's what true leadership shows you.
Yeah, well, he doesn't need to change much personally.
At the 34-yard line.
Second and nine now. Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
And it's third down.
This to Jarwin. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling